over in the UK, riots continue to sweep through towns and cities in the first widespread outbreak of violence in 13 years. Fires burned on the streets of Belfast, while in Plymouth, the several hundred anti-immigration protesters faced off against counter-protesters and kept apart by police. The fatal stabbing of three young girls last week has been seized on by anti-immigrant and anti-Muslim groups after disinformation spread on social media that the suspected killer was an Islamist migrant. British Prime Minister Keir Starmer giving his assurance of sufficient police presence, adding rioters are being dealt with.
Over 400 people now have been arrested. 100 have been charged, some in relation to online activity, and a number of them are already in court. And I'm now expecting substantive sentencing before the end of this week. That should send a very powerful message to anybody involved, either directly or online, that you are likely to be dealt with within a week, and that nobody, but nobody, should be involving themselves in this disorder.
Hamas names its Gaza leader Yahya Sinwar as a successor to former political chief Ismail Haniyeh. Sinwar is the architect of the October 7 Hamas attack on Israel. The move is seen as reinforcing the radical path Hamas has been pursuing. Sinwar has been in hiding in Gaza, defying Israeli attempts to kill him. He is the most powerful Hamas leader left alive since the assassination of Haniyeh in Tehran last week, which has left the Middle East on the brink of a wider regional conflict. Hezbollah vowing a strong and effective response to Israeli attacks. Hezbollah's chief leader, Sayed Hussein, says they will wait for the right moment, but gave no hint on the timing and form of his group's retaliation. Nasrallah spoke in a televised speech marking the one-week memorial of the group's top military commander who was killed in an Israeli airstrike. The race for the White House heating up as the Democratic Party ticket kicks off their campaign in the battleground state of Pennsylvania. U.S. Vice President Kamala Harris and Minnesota Governor Tim Walz sharing the stage in Philadelphia for the first time. The campaign rally comes hours after Harris announced her pick for her running mate. The Vice President's campaign then released a video of the moment Harris told Walz he was selected as his VP.
Hi, this is Tim.
It's Kamala Harris. Good morning, Governor.
Good morning, Madam Vice President.
Listen, I want you to do this with me. Let's do this together. Would you be my running mate and let's get this thing on the road?
I would be honored, Madam Vice President.
The joy that you're bringing back to the country, the enthusiasm that's out there, it'll be a privilege to take this with you across the country.
Well, let me tell you, I have just the utmost respect for you. I have really enjoyed our work together. You understand our country. You have dedicated yourself to our country in so many different and beautiful ways. And we're going to do this. We're going to win. And we're going to unify our country and remind everyone that we are fighting for the future for everyone. So let's get out there and get this done, okay?
Let's do it. Do the work in front of us. Let's win this thing.
That's right. All right, buddy. I'll see you soon. Take care. Thank you. Okay.
Yeah.
Bye.
Walz is a progressive policy champion seen to help Harris win over rural and white voters. As governor, he pushed for an agenda that includes free school meals, tax cuts for the middle class, and expanded paid leave for Minnesota workers. Prominent Democrats quickly embracing the party's tandem. U.S. President Joe Biden says Kamala Harris made a great decision in choosing Tim Walz to be her running mate. He adds the Harris-Walz ticket will be a powerful voice for working people and America's middle class. Biden also calls the two the greatest defenders of personal freedom and democracy. Former U.S. President Barack Obama praises Walz for being that government works to serve people. Former Secretary of State Hillary Clinton calling Walz an incredible partner for America's first woman president. Meanwhile, an analyst sees the Democratic ticket as a polar opposite of the Republican tandem of Donald Trump and J.D. Vance.
It's a very progressive ticket against a very conservative ticket. And so what we're seeing here is more evidence of the immense polarization of American politics, that neither candidate really felt like they needed to reach in a direction toward moderate voters in terms of their running mates' policies and priorities. In both cases, it's interesting, they've moved in toward the style of the moderate voter with J.D. Vance and kind of his Appalachian cred, and Tim Walz, a hunter and, you know, a rural Minnesotan. So we live in an era where style is pretty important. Perhaps one of Walz's strengths is that he can speak to the kind of voter that did not was not particularly drawn to Hillary Clinton in 2016. But evidently swung back toward Joe Biden in 2020, which is an older white moderate voter.
Republicans wasted no time in attacking the Harris-Walz tandem. The party's vice presidential hopeful, Senator J.D. Vance, said he is eager to debate his Democratic rival, provided that he is in fact the nominee. He also tried to paint Walz as someone who is too extreme to hold office.
So first of all, the reason I didn't say a whole lot about Tim Walz is because the Democrats have showed a willingness to pull a little switcheroo on us. So I don't even know if we're actually going to get Tim Walz out of this campaign. My view on it is it just highlights how radical Kamala Harris is. This is a person who listened to the Hamas wing of her own party and selecting a nominee. This is a guy who's proposed shipping more manufacturing jobs to China, who wants to make the American people more reliant on garbage energy instead of good American energy, and has proposed defunding the police just as Kamala Harris does.
Now let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our correspondent, Henny Espinosa.
Hey guys, here are news making headlines for Filipinos in North America.
A raging wildfire has devastated the western Canadian tourist town of Jasper. And officials say the fire, which has now burned through 84,000 acres, could burn for weeks, if not months. Up to 450 Filipino workers in Jasper are reportedly affected, and fellow Filipinos are organizing relief efforts.
I connected with several member communities in rural Alberta. At lima po yung nag-respond. We have Red Deer, Choshu, the Committee of Olds, Leduc, and of course, Bell. So may mga ano na po, mga pumapasok ng mga donations.
Kung inorganize natin yung grupo at nagpost tayo sa social media, sobrang nakakataba sa puso na patuloy yung pagsuporta ng ating mga kababayan at agad-agad silang sumagot sa ating panawagan na tulungan yung ating mga kababayan na naapektuhan ng wildfire sa Jasper.
And finally, artist Lani Mestros, her name is a painting of the name of Mary Jane Veloso, who has been in prison in Indonesia for more than 14 years now. The painting, currently on display at the Grant Gallery in Vancouver, has a QR code beside it that opens to a petition for the release of Veloso.
Lani wanted to make this work that was in response to, or that kind of referenced specifically her case, and to raise awareness of that, like, amongst like Filipino community and other communities that want to stand in solidarity with Mary Jane.
In 2010, Veloso was arrested, detained, and subsequently sentenced to death in Indonesia after she was found to have carried illegal drugs in her luggage. A global petition to stop her execution led to a reprieve, but she remains in Indonesia's death row.
We are still calling upon the Philippine government as Philippine nationals here, and also calling upon the Canadian government here, for those of us that are citizens, to actually have her legal rights, her human rights, to a fair trial, to be upheld, to actually free her.
And those are the news making headlines today. You can catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website, YouTube channel, and app. I'm Henny Espinosa. Back to you guys at the Rundown.